Morning. It's the 24th of July, garbage day. And I just finished this Lay's mask. So I decided working with Lay's, it would be better if I do a straightforward stitch and try the concave. Concave is a little messier. And this one was kind of very successful. Easy. So for this project, just do rectangle 3D. And since this string is so thin, instead of getting stuck in the sewing machine, I just work it by hand. Needles are very sharp. To be really careful when working so you don't puncture your fingers. And try to minimize using it. Less necessary. So here it is. I gave Dave a neon green and he wore it yesterday. If I look good. Well, that's good. I decide to do 3D because when he wore it. Doesn't look too bad. I could put it on my face and see how it looks. And basically that's 3D right there. I think I feel good about it too. And then I could go in my next project. Another 3D. I discovered earlier that the length that the width of it is a little too long, too wide, so this width would be a lot better. I needed at least 7 or 6 to cover my face. Just like this one. This one we got 7. Well, since we have seven. Seven. Perfect. So we have 3 7 here. Let's do the first 7. To make sure some of the pieces are not ripped, like this one right here. So sew it. Cut the extra pieces off. Lace is kind of hard to work with because they're easily ripped, and when they're in the washer machine, yeah. If you have thicker lace, like the one I saw at Walmart, the pink one, That would have been great. But I didn't get that one. I got this blue heel. Ooh. So this one I'm doing on the other side, which is kind of shiny. For children, it's probably, yay, shiny. The kids is like, or teenager, it would be like, depends. Okay. It wasn't worth that corner. Must be nice to live in a waterfront property. I was just thinking of the successful people in society. don't hold a scissor like that. It's the wrong way. The concave of it should be where the palm is, the fingers, not the other way around. So 3D is really easy to do. Especially lace. Like this. Laced. Like that. There it is. Voila. Laced. Went to sleep at 1. So involved with reading this novel. And now that I woke up, before I went to sleep, I said when I wake up, I will continue reading. Because I didn't finish it. Now that I've awakened, I didn't continue because, well, mainly because I need my morning exercise, and this is it. No. Multi-purpose. You get in your project. Exercise. And so, you know, you do stuff, but you also, you know, help yourself. So you're not like making excuses. Oh, I couldn't exercise. Gain weight. You know, I'm homebound. And I'm sick with obesity and eating too much sugar, junk food. So now I have diabetes. I have high blood pressure, too much potato chips. Because I'm, you know, Brontosaurus. Or Homebody. I'm bored out of my mind. So I don't want to exercise. Because I don't have means. Treadmill. That's not true. You have to eat that much. So isn't there a park out there? It's on the mine, right? The mind game. So you can do it. Another project done. Late. It's good to exercise in the morning because it's just refreshing. You eat, so you have to exercise. If you don't eat, you're probably not here. But if you eat food, plenty of calorie intake. You know? So, create your little gym in your trailer, in your RV. This treadmill is not that big. It's rather small. Regardless how much your size is, it could be 400, 500 pounds. I think. You just need to take it easy first. Probably walk around depending upon your weight. I want to walk around the house first. Then you create a habit, a repetition. Maybe around your house. See how you know your physical recommendation from your care provider, professional, parental, all the above, or your own. You know, body and your own body accepting your body accepting, you know, the asserted energy is. It looks kind of easy walking like this because I'm used to it and my weight is kind of like not too bad, but certain people, it might not be, you know, healthy, recommended. Well, for example, maybe you're a child and you don't know how to walk in a medicinal way. What does that mean? Or maybe you have it's not recommended for you, but for others, and myself, it's pretty simple. Just a walk. Some people even do, you know, severe, higher intensity running. But that's because they're young, bigger, or higher. Depends on the machine too, because I don't think my treadmill allow me to abuse it like that. It's just I didn't buy a very expensive machine. I just bought a working machine. I didn't buy one. Sole purpose was to extreme exercise. This is sort of meditational walk where you just let your mind go. And if, you know, you're fidgety with your hand occupied, and then you're verbally speaking just to, you know, let your mouth speak or whatever comes in your head. And of course, early in the morning, you just woke up. So, no bombardment of socialization, so you can just let it flow. Right? When you let your mind flow, which is easy to do, that's why they do a lot of Tai Chi in the morning. Just slow, therapeutic flow of energy. Let the body move. Best time, create a routine of getting energy expelled. So you can your body move. You can feel good about what you wear because it fits, and then you can also eat whatever you want because you exercise, so you burn. You burn the calorie, so you don't need to worry. About what you eat. You burned it. You need to put calories in so you can live, survive. It's the thing about the body. It needs calories to burn. So that's why you need to exercise. Then you can eat whatever you want. But if you don't, then you have to watch your intake. Watching your intake is kind of sad because society now promotes a lot of intake everywhere, fast food. And also, if you exercise, you burn calories, your stomach actually shrink. How do I know this? Personal experience. When I say shrink, meaning it might not apply to you that it doesn't shrink. You might be saying, oh, I exercise and I eat more. Probably given your age also is the reason for that explanation. You know, like when you're younger, you run or you exercise. Then you might. I thought I burned 2,000 calories through an hour of strenuous running up the hill and with great speed. And now I'm intaking 4,000 calories by eating fried egg rolls and fried chicken and high calories like lasagna and why am I craving for all those stuff? Well, first, I think it's in the mind. It's control. You ate those stuff probably because you're trying to replenish the calories that you burn. And craving is maybe because your body craves bad food when they're hungry. It doesn't crave a carrot, it craves one. You know, something that's the mind had tasted before. And remember, in its memory bank. So, you can kill 4,000 calories through long hours of hard labor, but you're gonna want to restore that with high calorie food. Otherwise, your muscle is the same. Wow, I build all this muscle. And what did I need to show for it, you know? I have to show me something in producing more muscle when you're burning calories and you're building, you know, muscle in a long haul. Like if you're running, you can build hamstring and calf muscle. If you're working on the upper body, probably building chest muscle, abdominal muscle, you're doing crunches, you're cycling, and all sort of other muscle because you don't just use one muscle group. That's why you exert more. But, you know, if you're walking on the treadmill and there's, you're actually building stamina, which is within your mind and soul. Not much muscle building because this is not exerting muscle extreme to build muscle, you need more weight bearing, I think. Don't quote me on that. My boost is burning, okay? Burning is also good. Burning calories. So another mass is done, so I did 3 this morning. And I'm still walking at 0.7 speed. I increased my speed today instead of 0.5. I'm doing 0.7. So I'm moving my leg a little more. Today, I got my legs. And then I think I have my last piece. I can do that too. Or I can do my reading. It's 10 o'clock. I can look to see I burned 192 calories. Distance, not even a mile, is 0.8. I did the machine. I've been running for an hour. I do have this one last piece. I can do that too. Or I can just stop. What in the name, right? Since I'm on a row, might as well just continue until I drop. Like, not drop, like physically dropping, but like, yeah. Tire mentally. That's what happened to people. Okay. Let's show this car down. Upset over the book that I'm reading. The heroine is blessed with, you know, gifted ability. And yet, she has to apologize for that with her husband. So I'm kind of upset that she married a guy who very wealthy, but and every girl wants her him, but because of his looks and his money and his talent. But she, on the other hand, has looks, talent, but no money. And for her to find money, she used her talent and skill. But the thing is, he's mad at her once he find out that she has those things. That's where I'm at, and I was really into the book because, you know, in life, when you lack something, you kind of, the book becomes so addictive. It hits kind of like for your own desire to have those superhuman quality, small people quality, the genius intelligent, the human quality, like photographic memory, like all of the above, like martial arts ability, courage. In addition to that, and speed, high energy, and of course, usefulness, young age, you know, ability to all those are given to her. One thing that wasn't given, many people were not given to her, is love from her family. Wealth, other things, gifted things, gives her a chance in society. So I'm taking this. Okay. And that's it. That will be my fourth mass for today. The bigger ribbon. That's the last one. To send more events. Wear it, then to know it. So I don't know how they're gonna feel. I will have to wear it when I go out. So this is my fourth mask. Placed. All right. Not only did I exercise, I got everything accomplished too. Thank you. Put in the name. Wow, it's getting hot. That's the temperature. Okay. So here's another one. 3D or rectangle. Until next time. Bye.